Right, two Mingays. Another Mingay here. And then right through there at the back, that Zara tidied all that up, and it had grown over again at one time in 19 years. And then I come, and now it's been tidied up again. That's Mark Oak's grave. I'll just zoom in. Zara spent a lot of time on her knees here, tidying up this area, because it was an oak. And we still don't know if he's ours yet, or if I might have done, I might have sorted it out by now. There's another Mingay here. Charles Heiner Mingay. Died 1976, age 74, and Blanche as well. Somebody really keeps these tidy, these ones, don't they? There's another Mingay over there. Wait a minute. We've got Florence Matilda Mingay, died 20th October 1983, age 88. And her husband, Sidney John Mingay, died the 29th of May 1984, age 86. So they died quite close to each other. Too. So Mingay is quite popular, but all this has been tidied since I was here last. Can't see that one. Yeah, they soon get emptied of their stones and everything, don't they? There's a little hardy patch. Yeah, there's hardies in here. There is an oak tree nearby that one. Another Mingay there. Reginald Alfred Mingay. Called home, 1932, age 29. Lots of Mingays. And I think they marry into people in our tree. Our picture of his grave. Something called Prince, I think, isn't it? I can't read that one. And this was harder to read. But I've got a feeling. Yeah, Mark Oak. 1935. But we've got it all written down before. We've got it all written down. Before. And he's in there. Zara spent a lot of time tidying up that little tiny area, exposing that grave. it was a lot worse. And this is wild, but it's a lot wilder than this. Alright, a lot wilder. These are the newer ones. I need another day really so I can do Wesley Waterless, which I think I should do. I'm sure musks were there. I wasn't really doing musks back then, see? These are all newish graves. I'm just going to turn off a little one of the. Of Zara. I'm further ahead of her and I took him back taking a picture of her. She walks along here with Maggie, with Brandy, the dog. And it just seems like last week and it was 19 years ago. 19 years ago and a couple of weeks. We spent a whole week doing grave work. We went everywhere and we were busy every day. Until it was dark, I had energy and I was organized, you know. Were you? Yeah. I was organized back in those days. So taking the top off that one, that used to have a big spike on it, it's over there. It's in the bushes. Just do these and I'll just go in the church. Everybody's doing their. Oh, there's a Clayton there. So, I might not have seen these. That looks like a new one. He's the same age as me, but he died. Born 52, died 2018. Just shows you never know. Sorry, she was spent here with walking with Brandy. She's doing around the oak. She's doing around there as well, she's showing it. Maybe she's related to it. She? Woman over there streaming around the oak grave. There was more than one oak there. There's so much tree work to do, you can get caught up on one line that takes you away. I got caught up with the stuck veils, you see. I have videoed in here before, and with a better camera. I remember that great big marble pulpit. I always remember that. I can't remember who she is. What's the date today? 5th. church. Well, I have done this church before. I'm not really stopping. Because it is quite a demanding job doing tree. When I was younger, like 10, 20 years ago, I never used to feel tired like I do. Since the COVID thing, I just feel drained a lot, and I've had Lyme's as well. So I try and do what I can. And I'd like to spend longer. I mean, I'd like to be up here so I didn't feel tired and I could do the walks. Somebody's pulling the bell, isn't it? Well, that didn't do 11, did it? It's stuck on 12. Did some. Look at that big old tree, that. Look at the size of that. That's been here a long time. That was here when the ancestors were here. Yeah, definitely. There's a Frederick Pryke underneath who died in 1908, aged 64. Prykes we find at Wickenbrook. There are some Prykes over that way. And they might have been tied up with the Isaacsons. Right, Dullingham, I don't know when I'll be back again, Dullingham. I'd like to stay longer, but I've got other churches to do. Right, I think what I need is I've got some hot water in the flask from yesterday, just hoping it'll be alright. Well, we've got ancestors from the past here. Down the bottom there, you've got a pub called The Boot. And they used to do camping there in the past. In the past, they used to do camp. You could put your tent up and stay there in the past. It's got a big marquee up in there at the moment. Lovely big tree, look. Gorgeous big old tree that is.